Valhalla'da 3. bölüm. Okey, şimdi sigortamız bu anında konuşacağım, dedim nerede olacak?
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
Yok, edemez. Reach off.
It's Eivor! Open the door! Come in! Keep your voice down! You will alert Harald's men!
Where will we live?
The English will fight back! The wars will never end!
Or they will push us into the Christian ways!
Quiet all! Give me a chance to speak! Two days ago, we rid this land of Kjotve and his dogs. Yet today, we do not celebrate. Today we cower under a cloud of fear. But it need not be like this. We are not the heel-trodden subjects of a boy king. We are the Raven Clan. Our destiny is our own.
Did you know about your father's oath to Harald?
I did not. And for that, my anger burns hotter than any man's here. But I will not let that drive me into despair. We cannot stay in Norway. Not under Harald's boot. Not without fueling more war. So we push forward to newer lands. To England. And there make a new home. A kingdom of our own.
The sons of Ragnar Lothbrok have been in England 8 winters already. Is there any land left for a clan of our size?
More than enough, wife. Of the 4 kingdoms of England, only one is truly pacified.
I have no desire to wear Harald's leash. I like this idea.
A saga for the ages, I agree.
It will take time and resources to build ourselves a new home, but the riches taken from Kjotve's raid would suffice.
No. That belongs to my father, as a fair compensation. In England, we must start anew.
You would start us with nothing, in a land we do not know, among people who hate us?
Kjotve's riches would go some way to easing our passage, Sigurd. I bested him. It is within my rights to claim his goods.
Our leaving must not be an assault on my father. It is a time of renewal for us.
Okay.
If you object, I understand. Let your father keep Kjotve's riches. England will have riches and cargo enough for us.
Good. I did not want this cloud hanging over us. It is a wise leader who considers the need of others.
To England then, before the day is out. Pack what you need, but no more than that.
And tighten your lips. The last thing we need is the attention of Harald's troops. How much did you hear?
Enough. A new path is revealed, and your journey will be challenging.
Will you not join us?
For my mother's sake, I cannot. But our threads will cross again before the final day. Until then, farewell.
Farewell. Valka.
Eivor, the wind favors us. We should set sail without delay.
You made quick work of packing. Well done.
The dream of new lands is a powerful lure.
As is the promise of glory. But the act of leaving so beloved a home, there is a sadness to it.
Having doubts?
No, not at all. The die is cast.
Then let fate guide our journey. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let us take to the water and leave unbothered while we have the chance.
That chance is past. Look!
Fate flies on swifter wings than we.
King Harald's banner. Sigurd? What is this assembly? What are you planning? An exit, father. As graceful as I can. For if I cannot be king in the land of my birth, I will start a new saga. In England.
Nonsense. Your place is here, son, at my side. There will be other victories soon. Other glories.
My choice is made, father. Do not hope otherwise.
Styrbjorn Jarl. Our men were killed as we patrolled nearby. And the word is, Eivor swung the axe.
If the dead could speak, what would they say of their deaths, Wolfkist?
They would tell you how they offered us insults, and how I slew them for it.
As the dead cannot defend themselves, a fair geld is wanted. 50 weight of silver for each life. By law.
50 weight?
You will have it from me. A parent must pay the price of his children's folly.
That was generous, Lord.
Why England? Why throw away all you have for such an uncertain future? Here you could be a king's hero, Eivor. Your name known all across Harald's many kingdoms.
No. I will not be captive to another man's gaudy design. My destiny is my own to weave.
Eivor speaks for both of us, father. You gambled your honor and you lost your family. I hope the trade was worth it.
Anger and sadness wrestle for my heart, but I am glad you'll leave this place alive.
Sacks of wool? Put some muscle into those pools!
Ration your strength, Mark. We have an ocean to cross.
All right, you lazy backrout. Sigurd, what's our course?
The sons of Ragnar established a settlement near the coast. We set sail for them. Ragi, sing a song to lift our hub.
To rouse the gods! Inspire a mighty fart from Thor to speed us on our way!
An ocean lies before us, Eivor. And on its far side, a new kingdom awaits.
You know England well from your travels.
I spent a season in their kingdom of Mercia, a temperate land, lush and wild. By now, the sons of Ragnar will have claimed its heart.
Do we mean to join their army?
They will join ours. In time, all of England will know of Ravenclan and the glory we brought to that fractured land. So to England, glory and destiny!
To England!
To England! Por Valhalla!
Told a worried audience that scientists have few answers for them.
Since the
a mass coronal ejection of 2012, the strength of the Earth's magnetic field has increased by a factor of 50,000. This has resulted in huge disturbances in radio and satellite communications, dangerous bands of radiation around the poles, and as we can all see from our window, an aurora borealis that never burns away. Unfortunately, we are stumped as to why this is happening, and if we cannot find an answer soon, it may change the way we live, the way we communicate, even the way we evolve, forever.
Dr. Sirka went on to say...
Bought you more electrolytes? Oh, new and improved citrus flavor.
Thanks, Sean. How do we fix this? How are you the key to everything?
Hey, what is it that I know?
You're a long way from home, Eivor.
Aynen. Şşş, hızlı koşuyor.
I should do this more often. Relaxing. Into town than use this.
Şurası kazı alanı zaten. No, aynen. Şurada ne var? Pardon.
It's beautiful. That's not normal.
Tea is not actually tea, Bex. It's an infusion. It's really just dirty, minty water.
I don't care what you call it, Sean. Did you buy any?
Of course I did, love.
Hey, sorry about pulling you out. The generator was sputtering.
That's fine. I needed air.
How is the Animus data stream? Comfortable?
Felt pretty stable after a while.
Good. Just give me a sec and you can jump back in.
Okay.
Another satellite came down. Did you see?
I did. One of Abstergo's.
That's good.
Well, most of North America just lost its GPS service, so depends what you mean by good, really.
Right. Even when we win, we lose.
Okay, we're all set. Whenever you're ready, you can jump back in.
Hello, Layla.
Sean, what do you make of the grave out there?
Well, it overturns a few hundred years of scholarship about the first Europeans to set foot in North America. Apart from that, it's just a bunch of muddy bones, isn't it?
Can we talk about this thing on my neck for a second?
Ah, the mood stabilizer. Yes.
It's not harmful, is it? I mean, I feel good, but I want to make sure there's no side effects.
There shouldn't be. It's only blocking outside signals. A passive effect. So the staff doesn't, you know, mess with you.
Sean, what happened last year, I had no control over that. I tried to resist.
I understand. And your old team? Maybe they don't. but we've seen that sort of thing before.
Still,
you want to work with us and get to the bottom of why the world is about to end for the second time in 8 years, then you wear that thing until we say otherwise. William's orders.
I know. It's not a problem.
It's just a few more weeks, yeah? Just until we figure this out.
You're right. I know you're right. Sean has been busy.
Bilinmeyen bir yerden şifresini ucumuza gönderilen bir ses kaydı parçası hiçbir şey çalınmamış, o zaman olmuş. Girip çıkmışlar, bu sefer şanslıydık. Neydi peki, gizemli bir ses de sesi bilmiyoruz ama gömülü bir sinyalde kodu var. Bize burada yeni İngiltere'de belirli bir yere getirdi. Kazdık ve aman yarabbi turnayı vurduk yani, buralarda turna gezmez ama anladın. Olay şu, burası bir mezar, milattan sonra 9. yüzyılın sonu. 10'un başına tekabül eden bir Kuzeyli Savaşı. Bilmenin erken yerleşimciden 1400 yıl önce önceymiş. Doğru anladıysak sansiyonel bir şey. Sorular hala merak et. Bu kemikler buraya nasıl, neden gelmiş falan filan.
You gonna put this in the fridge, Sean?
Of course. In half a minute.
Remember, tomatoes go on the counter, not the fridge. Please enjoy your stay. Remember, all the garbage must be packed out, and please water the plants once a day.
Yeah, I won't remember that. I went through hell to bring you here. It had better be worth it. That's quite nice. Soothing. Let's have a look.
What's that good, sir? Gönderen Rami Hasan, tarih 11 Mayıs 2020. Cevap hayır. Her şeyi bu kadar açıkça anlattığım için teşekkürler, artık rahatça uyuyabilirim. Hayır, Covid olmadı mı? Ayrıca etrafta kimse yok. 3 kişi gözden uzak. Beraber seyahat ediyoruz. Ucu hiç sevmedim Layla. Ucu da nereye çıkacak korkuyor. Beni yetiştirmek için telefon kullanmıyorum. Falan demem hiç doğru değil. Telefonun biliyorsan arasan iyi edersin. Ayrıca hayır, bize gidere senden selam söylemeyeceğim. Yoksa cevaplamayacağım, bir dünya soru vardır. Babamı hapislere geçip çalışmaya bıraktığını söylesem yıkılır herhalde. Kızın anatolojide önce çalışmaları yaptığını anlatıp duruyor. Yaptığında yapacakların hakkında ufak bir fikri yok ama yine de gurur duyuyor. Ona el kırık bunlar atmayacağım. Covid mi oldun? O yüzden mi okuyacağım? Başka bir şey mi var? Babama ya da beni arap saklamaya bir son verelim. Ben de onu önlemek istiyorum. E-posta kısalını affet. Aramak istedim ama şu an telefonumu kullanmıyorum ve zamanım sınırlı. Okumak isteyenler için şöyle gösteriyorum. Assassin's Creed Origins'te olan şeyler değil mi ya? Üç müydü? Cennet Asası. Sarı ile ilgili bir konum var. Faydalanan fotoğraflar.
In my dreams, I see an end to the doom that will grip the earth once again. Find the Wolfkist. Find the Mad One. Find me. And save us all from another death.
Layla, thought you might be interested in this. Conversations that Bex and I had with Desmond back in 2012. December, I think. Just candid talks, that's all. We didn't square any circles or write any beat poetry. But he did have some interesting insights into his time in the Animus and what it means to be an assassin. Anyway, have a listen. You might find you and he had similar experiences. So, well, let me know what you think. Unless it's to tell me I sound like a total prat in these recordings. If that's the case, just say nothing. I mean, I did have a slight cold at the time I recorded these. That's probably why I sound odd. Anyway, okay, I'm done anyway, so turn off. Turn off. Oh, it's actually just a button. Sorry, here we go.
No, come on, Sean. Turn that thing off.
Oh, hold on. I like what you said there. I want to get this for posterity. Say it again, nice and loud.
Seriously?
Sure, come on. If nothing else, it'll give me leverage with your old man.
Ah, that's your angle. Nice. What I said was, I wish I hadn't been born into the Assassins. I wish I had chosen this life. Is that good enough?
Sure, but why is that?
Because choice is the central idea of our creed. It underpins everything, right? It's about free will. It's about seeing the evidence before you and saying, yes, this is what I want. Or, no, this isn't for me. But when you're born into a group like this, or any other, like I was, you get mixed signals. You get told over and over again, this is what we believe. These are the rules. This is reality. No deviation. And if you question it, oh, they look at you like you killed a puppy. That's hardly free will. It's a weird irony when free will is your central belief, but nobody wants you to believe otherwise. I don't know how to say it exactly, but I always thought there was something self-destructive about our creed. If free will is the most important moral guidepost we have, we should be free to ignore it, to choose submission, for example. You know what I mean? Like, we should be free to side with the Templars. If it's really my choice, I could do that.
Right. It's almost self-refuting. A democracy could democratically elect a dictator or choose to get rid of democracy altogether. Within our creed is the seed of its own destruction. That's what makes it powerful, I think. And fragile.
Right. The more freedom you have, the more risky it is, you know? Anyway, my dad has mellowed over the years, but he was strict when we lived on the farm. He ran a tight ship. I never got the impression that I was free to choose my path forward. Our creed, our tenets, they were drilled into my head. By the time I was a teenager, I was following these rules out of a sense of duty. This was just what we did.
That happens to a lot of organizations over time. The stagnation sets in, you know? The fundamentalism.
Yeah. Following the rules becomes more important than achieving whatever goal you set out for yourself. And people start to lose sight of the reason the rules exist.
That's called deontology, or a form of it. Following a rule for its own sake and not for the consequences it has.
Yeah, but that feels backwards, doesn't it?
Well, I think so. Following a rule is the easy part. Praying, taking a sip of wine, munching on a wafer. Rituals that give comfort.
But that's just going through the motions. It makes people feel like they're doing something. When the hard work is, well, actually getting off your ass and doing something productive. I think people just want boundaries. Tight boundaries. They want to see the four walls that pen them in.
I don't disagree.
Anything outside that, anything that makes life more complex, that's scary. That's why I envy you. You chose this life. You went through that process, and you decided, yes, I believe in this.
Sure. It didn't stop me from being an insufferable know-it-all as a teenager, but I see your point.
I would have loved to have been a know-it-all. I knew nothing, Not until you guys found me. Yeah. It wasn't until I met you and Bex and Lucy that I knew. I knew I wanted to be an assassin. Oh, thanks, Des. Come here.
Desmond.
Bring it in, bud. I don't normally like touching, but I'll make an exception now. I am not hugging you. You sure? Because I smell very nice today. Can you just turn that off?
Ben ne konuştun be? Desmond.
Hold on, I'll just set this here.
Do you guys record everything we talk about?
Not everything. But you've been using the Animus so much, I thought this was a good chance to learn some things about prolonged exposure.
So I'm your guinea pig?
No, no, my guinea pigs are all dead. The Animus was too much for them to handle.
Cute.
Can I ask you about the bleeding effect? Any recent flashes? Any memories resurfacing?
Yeah, the usual things. Ghost images of Altair and Ezio a few times a day. Nothing intrusive, just brief moments. They pass quickly, almost without me noticing. Like a figure in the corner of my eye, or remembering a dream from the night before. I did have one extended hallucination a few days ago. It was Ezio. He was older, around the time he left Cappadocia. He was standing on the deck of a ship, alone. And through him, I could feel an intense regret or guilt. And it felt to me like he'd had a loss of faith in himself, in the creed, like he couldn't keep it up, couldn't stay true to his ideals. And as I watched him, I thought, is this the moment he decided he was done being an assassin? It felt like it. Anyway, most of my visions have been brief, lasting just a few seconds. They're like complete memories of small moments that appear suddenly out of nowhere, fully formed. It's a strange feeling.
Okay, anything else?
I'm starting to see Connor now, too. Though I hear his voice more often than I see him. I'm sure that will change. Oh, yeah, and yesterday, just before bed, I had a memory of being on a beach in the Caribbean with a bunch of sailors. Or maybe they were pirates. I don't know. No idea.
Huh. I'll look into that. And how do you feel in general?
In general? Well, I feel older, for one. Much older. And it's strangely comforting. I'm collecting the memories and skills and thoughts of so many people. I feel like I've lived a few hundred years or more. Is it possible that if I do this for too long, it'll push my own memories aside? That I'll be everyone but myself after a while?
It's possible. That's called identity substitution. It's happened before, but it's rare. And someone with your background shouldn't need to worry.
My background? You mean someone with my genes? My abilities?
You have Isu DNA, and that lets you see things and do things and withstand traumas that other people can't.
And I can suffer in ways that others can't. That's not something to be proud of.
You mean the apple?
Yeah. It has a pull, Bex. It tugs at my brain. It talks to me. Teases me. Drives me mad. And what I did to Lucy. God damn it. Nothing is worth the damage I did. The pain I caused.
I know. But you're special. That's the point.
I'm not special, Bex. I'm lucky. That's all.
I understand.
We're assassins. It's our creed that makes us different. Not our genes. Not our blood. Anyone can join us.
That's true. But let's leave that aside for a second. What I want to know is, have you ever had any Isu memories resurface?
Isu memories? I don't think so. I can't even begin to imagine what that would feel like.
I think you'd know if you did. Maybe one day. We might be able to induce something.
Jesus, let's fix the world first, okay? Before we start digging up my ancient ancestors.
Deal.
With my luck, I'll be related to some third-rate Isu like Sisyphus or something.
Way to aim high, buddy.
Hey, you gotta.
Ne konuştun be kral ya? Şu güvenli paylaşım ne kapalı? Dosyalara baktık. Posta kutusuna baktık. Ama başka bir şey kalmadı çöp kutusuna. Buraya zaten girdik. Tam çıkış yap. Üf, ne konuştu ya?
Feeling okay?
Better. But I'm worried that it could happen again. The two data streams.
I can't promise it won't. I barely understand it myself.
It felt like two minds fighting over one brain. It hurt like a shotgun to the head.
Right. There's something about this Viking's DNA sample that feels dense, noisy.
Could it be the staff interfering somehow?
How do you mean?
My headaches, my temper. They started the day I got that thing.
I hope you're not making excuses for, you know, your friend.
Jesus, no. I'm not.
Sorry. Just take it easy. And if you feel yourself slipping again, let us know.
I'm trying. I really am.
Okay. Oraya baktık. Şöyle bir
Sean, don't forget to water the plants while I'm under, okay?
I'll add it to the calendar. I'll tattoo it on my leg.
Be nice to sleep in a real bed when this is over.
Bir soba var. Tamam. Artık oyunumuza girebiliriz.
All right, time to go. Norway to England takes about a week by long ship, so I'll scrub ahead. Layla, you okay?
Sorry. Can you play the message again?
We have the transcript. If you're looking for something, I can
go
and... No,
I want to hear it.
Okay.
I don't mean to be cryptic. It's just... That message led us here. To this place. To a Norse grave in North America. So those bones out there are the only lead we have. Our only chance at fixing this planet before it's too late.
Here it is.
I lived, I died, and now I sleep. And in my sleep, I dream. And in my dreams, I see an end to the doom that will grip the earth once again. Find the Wolfkist. Find the Mad One. Find me. And save us all from another death.
Unsettling, that is.
That pulse in the message, are you sure it's just coordinates? Nothing else?
Nothing I can find.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go.
I'm glad to see any land at all, and will be happy to have my feet on solid ground again.
We must not rush our landing. All you see here is Saxon territory, the Kingdom of Mercia, largely unpacified. There will be eyes watching us from the trees, with bows drawn and traps set. We must be wary. Randvi, take in your oars, all standing.
Have you spotted something?
Not yet. Well, let us go ahead to clear the path of any dangers. Then follow our lead when the sun brushes the horizon.
Understood. May Thor bless you all on your way. We will see you soon.
Sail on.
Yes, I'm ready for whatever these green-thumbed fairy folk have to throw at us.
Sigurd, do the sons of Ragnar know that we are coming?
They do not, but they will not scoff at our visit. Of the four kingdoms in England, the sons of Ragnar have settled only one. The rest is ripe for the taking.
Do we mean to join their army?
No. No. We will speak with them. Get the lay of the land. And carve this country into as many pieces as we see fit.
Look ahead there! Is that what passes for a town? Plain brick and a single rune to their timid god?
That rune is called a root, Dag. The cross upon which their god was sacrificed. It sits atop a monastery, a place of worship.
That cross killed their Christ, and now they display it in worship? Bizarre.
We carve idols of our gods and make wishes before them, like our sacrifices to Odin, the One-Eyed.
But we do not worship the wolf that kills him. That is the difference.
Whatever strangeness we see in these Saxons, they must think the same of us.
The hammer! Now there is a symbol worthy of a god. A bolt of lightning would take that cross clean off.
Okay, de şu kontrolü bana ver artık ya.
Look there! What are they doing?
Ritual drowning.
Baptism, Dag. Are the ways of Christians really so unfamiliar to you?
Not at all. I simply forgot. And someone has to keep the conversation up. It must be priests and worshippers alone in that place. We could storm this port with ease. Sack it without breaking a sweat.
Is there much in the way of treasure there?
Always! They shape precious metals and cup jewels to their gods. There will be a fortune there.
Later, Dag. There will be time enough for raiding once we have settled. Come to. Stop the boats. Pull up over there. The way forward is blocked by a chain spanning the river. We must remove it before passing on.
A chain? Can we cut through it?
It's too thick for access. But there must be a way to release it somewhere in that camp.
I will go.
And I will be right behind you.
No, Dad. You stay here. Should trouble come our way, I want you defending the ship.
A good idea. Send out the arrow and keep your sharpest axe at hand, huh?
Something like that.
White Lord, what's got into you?
Okay. Tamam hadi. Şurada bir tane var. Tek yedi tamam. Mutlu oynadığımız için otomatik olarak şey oluyor bunlar. Zaten tüm skill'leri fulllediğimiz için modla beraber. İçin bu engellerin daima sağlam bir işlev bulunduğumuzu, işlevde herhangi bir hatanın derhal belirmesi gerekir. Şimdiki... Titanium. Nasıl gördüm? Evet, anlayın sana. Şurayı da kır.
Surprises.
work.
I say we go back, Sigurd. Give those dogs a good knock around and take whatever treasures they have. Easy pickings.
Not today, Dad. We press on until we reach our goal. We cannot afford another surprise. Now be on your guard. It should not be far.
Gods, I'm ravenous. I hope they have food and ale on hand when we arrive. We should have sent word ahead of us, Sigurd, to get something on the spit.
If Halfdan, Ubba and Ivar Ragnarsson are lacking food in England, then all of us will starve. Have no worry. Oh, I can see it now.
A suckling pig, tender and juicy, and ale as gold as the treasures that we failed to steal back there.
A man of simple pleasures, aren't you, Dag?
And he is happier for it. For my part, I look forward to standing in the footsteps of the giants that built this land.
What giants?
The great Romans and their empire. Giants of a forgotten age. They held dominion here long ago, and their ruins dot the landscape. Every brick and stone tells a story of conquest and glory. And now, they are rubble and ash.
Ready to be remade. We will rebuild their empire, brick by brick. And ours will not crumble to dust.
All things end, Dog. Ruins are not a warning. They're a testament. Look there, just ahead. Where the sons of Ragnar make their camp.
At last, to find our feet on steady ground.
Sigurd, hold back. Something isn't right.
Good eye. There's too little movement for an army. Only tents and a few men.
Not the army we hoped to find.
No. Let us get a closer look.
Those are not Norsemen. They're too ragged and soiled.
We should proceed on foot, lest they spot the boats.
Thag and I will go together.
We all go. If they are friends, I wish to meet them as a jarl. And if they are foes, then we fight them all together. Who are these men?
They speak with twisted accents. English, no doubt.
Dag, Eivor, on me.
A mess of filthy Danes befouling our riverways. You there, give us your name.
I am Sigurd Jarl of Fornberg, and you are...
Men who do not take kindly to Dane invaders creeping into our camp. You'd best move along, pagan. Spare yourselves a slaughter.
You threaten Norsemen with a play of swords and expect us to cower?
I have been 8 days at sea without a drop of blood to wet my axe. So spare the chatter, Buckrout, and draw your weapon.
Oh! Let's finish them!
Kill these bastards!
Stop it! all of you. I want no more surprises.
Right. Okay. I'll check the longhouse.
Tam kampı buraya yapacağız zaten. Yazık var da da okey.
Are you with those Pickens as well?
Sigurd, Dag, in here. Those men had prisoners.
You there, untie us. Let us walk and we will not hurt you.
Quite bold in those bindings. I like your spirit.
We are very agreeable people, I promise. You need not kill us.
Peace, friend. We have no need or wish to hurt you. What are your names?
Yenli. I'm a merchant, not a bandit like those others. And this is Rowan.
Rowan, that's right. I'm a stable hand, that's all. I keep horses and, well, I did, till those brigands sold them off.
They meant to sell us next, as slaves to the nearest bidder. But I read their eyes out before I let that happen.
And how did you find yourselves here?
We came to trade with the Sons of Ragnar, at Halfdan Jarl's asking. But they were gone when we arrived.
Unbind them. You know the Sons of Ragnar?
Aye. Sold many a mare and stallion to the brothers. Good men. Always paid me fair.
From the look of this camp, they've been gone for some time. Where will you go now? What will you do?
Rebuild my stocks? Start anew? I have friends and allies across the land to aid me. But it won't be easy.
Every town and village needs a stable to keep horses fit and trim. I'll find my footing again, somewhere.
What are you thinking?
That we could use their skills as we get settled. Having access to trade and someone to tend our mounts would be a boon.
My thoughts as well. Any friend of the Ragnarsons is a friend of mine. Right, Dag?
Whatever you think is best, Sigurd.
Yanli, Rowan, I am Sigurd Jarl of Thornberg, son of Styrbjörn. This is Eivor and Dag. Both of you are free to go, but more than welcome to stay if you're willing to pull your weight.
We'd be happy to, if only to get back on our feet.
Then let it be done. The Raven Clan welcomes you. From strangers, into friends, into family. The others have arrived. Come.
I have a good feeling about this place.
Honored family, friends, welcome to your new home. Any I've seen. Now come. Randvi has found something I would like you to see.
Eivor, Sigurd, I give you England and its four kingdoms. Mercia, East Anglia, Northumbria, and Wessex. From the few plans and maps I discovered here, I believe the Sons of Ragnar have pushed further into Mercia, here. My scouts will soon tell me if I am correct.
And where are we?
Here, in this unnamed copse of trees.
Unnamed? We cannot let that stand. What will we call this place?
I might have an idea.
Ravensthorpe, the village of ravens.
I like it. The poet in you sings once again. One day this name will be known throughout all of England.
A name is only a beginning. If we want renown, we must build. Expand.
Agreed. We should begin with a forge. Can you help Gunnar get working again?
We'll need cargo, supplies.
For that our neighbors will provide, whether they wish to or not.
Scarcely arrived, and now we must raid.
We cannot master this land merely by asking.
I'll go and speak with Gunnar now.
Good work, my dear. And what else have you found?
Short notes, mostly. Scraps of plans, weapons. A few runestone messages. It took some time to decipher the mess and piece it all back together.
Okay, şimdi... Buraya işimiz bitti. Tamam, burayı geliştireceğiz işte, erzak vesaire yağmalayarak. Ki modlu oynadığımız için bütün bunlar ücretsiz olacak. Yani hile gibi ama işte yapacak bir şey yok. Şimdi...
Not a bad place, Eivor. Not at all. Can I help you with anything?
Sigurd wants your forge up and running as soon as possible. For that, we need supplies and riches.
Ah, you mean to go a Viking then? Good, good. How I miss those days. Ransacking and pillaging. Blade singing and shield splintering.
I would ask you to join us, but you are the only blacksmith we have. We cannot afford your loss.
Oh, it's no bother. Better I forge axes than swing them. My place is here, not pulling on the oar of a river horse. Though you do remind me, I've found a map among the bandits' rubbish, marked up with the locations of Saxon monk huts.
Yes, bandits know as well as we do. Monasteries are full of riches and loot.
Take the map with you. And put it to better use than they did.
Okay. Dünya haritasını aç diyor. Ama burada yağmalanacak yerler var. Tamam. Şöyle. Gemi komutatı. Okay. Manastır baskını. Bundan ganimet alacağız.
For the good of our clan, it is time we go a Viking. Today we raid, that tomorrow we may build. At last, we will crack these Christian monasteries like a row of hen's eggs.
The Saxons know we are here, though. The monasteries will be well guarded.
Ah, but nothing more than priests and prayers, I'd wager.
You salt skulls, got a story?
Here's a tale to tickle your sides. The winter before, I was drinking in Stavanger with some companions. With us in the mead hall were men of Bard Jarl's clan, one of which was a poet named Halli, called Sarcastic Halli by most. 7 ale horns into his night, Halli stood upon his table and called continually. Look there, monastery.
About it.
Or we slay every last man and take all the time we need.
Should we be so lucky?
To arms!
Bunları tek açamıyorsanız şunları zor olacak.
Hey! Can't do this alone.
So soon, and with good news, I hope.
I think so.
Ah, this is wonderful labor. A forge bigger and hotter than my old forge back in Thornburg. Come visit me anytime. For weapons and gear, there is no man better than me.
I will, Gunner. Have no doubt.
Tamam, yerleşkenin inşası falan filan.
Hello and well met.
Bir saniye, şuradan modu aktif edeceğim. Araları yine yanmaları sorun yok da. Şimdi item. Item ne yapıyorsun? Seninle niye konuşamıyoruz?
Item. Now that you and Basim are settled, what will you do?
We have work to do. Starting in the cities of England. London, Jorvik, Winchester. All three are infested by members of the same order to which Kjotve belong. But their reach extends much further than this. Of all the lands on Earth, I believe England is the most overrun.
Do they cause here the same turmoil Kjotve caused in Norway?
Not just turmoil. They spread a plague of delusion, teaching men and women to abase and abuse themselves in exchange for power.
You have strong feelings about this.
Of course. This is the sole purpose of the Hidden Ones. To liberate the body and spirit of man from any other...
Pardon?
...natural shackles. But we have not operated in England for over four centuries. Since the fall of the Roman Empire, the Hidden Ones have not had a presence here. This absence has given the Order of the Ancients ample room to grow and thrive. Our task will not be an easy one. But with a bureau, Basim and I could begin our work. If you have the time and spare resources to build one, we would be most grateful.
I will see what I can do.
Var var, merak etme. Item burada tarikat izini sürermiş. Modla oynadığımız için her şey free.
will make a fine space for my work, Eivor. Thank you.
Well, if your work benefits us, I will see that you keep it for as long as you live among us.
I believe it will, for we have common cause against our enemy. They have dug their claws deep into England. Eradicate them where they are strongest, and the alliances you seek will be far easier to come by. In London, they now operate without restraint. If you were to eradicate them, the city would be in your debt.
I will talk with Ranri about your idea. Get her thoughts.
Good. Yet, before you do, there is something else. A gift I wish to share.
A gift?
I cannot show you here. Will you walk with me?
I will. Lead on.
Daha sonra bakacağız.
I hear heaviness to your breathing, Hytham. Does your wound still trouble you?
It does, I'm afraid. There is a pain in my chest for which I have no remedy.
Rest easy, then. So long as your mind stays sharp, you will recover.
Of course. Though I am reluctant to displease my mentor.
You would risk your health and your life to please Basim. That I do not understand.
I should not expect you to. When we first arrived, I noted a shadow of suspicion in your eyes. A doubt. A wariness.
Is that a question?
No. Only an observation.
Are you well enough to steer this boat?
I am. Have no worry. It is only prolonged stresses that exhaust me. My energy runs low rather quickly.
Gel. Cama çıkacak. Ne çıkamıyorum onunla. Çıkmaya çıkar, biz anlamadan es.
What is this gift you wish to give me?
It will not come from me. It is a gift you must give yourself.
More riddles. What fun you are.
Let me say it another way. My gift is not for giving or taking. It is a way of living.
But still no clearer.
It is a thing better demonstrated than described.
Then I will wait.
Forgive my jest. This gift we call a leap of faith. It is one of our brotherhood's most sacred rites. It is not a tool we use against our enemies, but an act we embrace to strengthen our resolve. Like your meditation, it centers our minds, steadies our hands, and purges fear from our hearts. And more practically, it aids our movements, in flight or in stealth.
You call it a leap. We are climbing a rather steep hill.
There it is again. The shadow of a doubt. Nearly there. Our destination is there.
I suspect you mean to throw me from this cliff, is that it? Please tell me if I'm near the mark.
And spoil the surprise? To perform the leap of faith, you must give yourself over to something greater.
The gods?
Yourself. Embrace the hope that death will not come before you are prepared to meet it. Believe this, and you will fear nothing.
Our deaths are prefigured, weaved into the fabric of the world. To fear this would be a waste of worry and tears.
Good. Then your mind is already attuned to my lesson. I will leap first. On my word, you must follow. Lean into your faith, into your strength, and take flight.
You want me to jump from here?
Yes.
I would sooner grow wings and fly away. Thank you for the lesson, but...
Wait! And watch!
Hide them!
Hytham! Pig-headed fool! Are you injured?
You see? My faith grew stronger than my fear!
And that loam cushioned your fall.
Eivor! I have not seen this side of you before! Do not feed your fear! Conquer it!
I've seen my death in a vision. It was not here. Not today. Yeah!
A perfect fall! And how did it feel?
You spoke true. It was madness and vigor. A purging of fear. A gift I give myself. I see that now. Thank you for showing me the way.
Of course. And thank you, Eivor, for hearing me out.
You called this leap of faith a sacred rite. Do all Hidden Ones practice this same ritual?
As far as I know, it is a rite of initiation that dates back to just before the birth of the Christian Jesus.
Are you hoping to initiate me?
I might try if I believed you would join, but that is not my purpose in England. Basim and I are hunting larger prey.
The Order of Ancients.
Yes. You remember the medallion you took from Kjotve's body? That is their symbol. They are a plague, one we hope to purge from this world. Like us, they act in secret. But their aim is to rule the world, not free it from unnatural fetters.
The desire to rule is not unique to this order. Sigurd and I want the same, a land to call our own, and the honor that comes with it.
Do not compare yourself to such people. The Order has no honor, no principles, no humanity. Yet they sit on a great many of England's thrones. If you seek to pacify England for the safety of your clan...
Then it may be in my interest to give you aid. I understand.
You desire alliances. We seek to rid England of its deepening rot. Where these hopes meet, our cause does too. You may think this land ruled by harmless jarls and bumbling thanes, yet look more closely, and you will find a deeper threat. The Order's invisible hand touches all. It shapes everything, instilling its poison into every level of society. From the lowliest fishmonger to the richest merchants, from wealthy thanes to useless kings, the Order has corrupted all. Basim has given me one task here. To locate and eliminate the Order of Ancients in England, in whatever dark corners they reside. If we work together towards this end, it will benefit us both. You will have greater influence over the kingdoms of England.
And you will have more medallions to count.
Exactly. You should begin in London. I have credible reports that the Order is working now to seize the city.
I will speak with Ranbry about this.
And while you are there, be on the lookout for our symbol. Centuries ago, the Hidden Ones had bureaus built around England. There were six, I believe. If you can find them, search them well for documents bearing the same symbol. It will greatly aid my studies.
I will. Thank you, Hytham, for all of this.
Kadimler tarikatını açtık. Paralı askerler, tarikat üyeleri, Odise'de olduğu gibi. Hiyerarşisi. İpuçları edinebilirsin diyor. Mesela şu ölen. Paladin, Kuvatke, Balta. Zorlu kış mevsimleri ve yağmalarla geçen günler her kuzeyli olduğu gibi Üretkeni de sert bir adam haline getirmiştir. Ne var ki insan öldürmekten ekstra bir zevk de alırmış. Gezgin bir tüccar potansiyelini görmüş ve onu tarikatla tanıştırmıştı. Böylece genç bir Kengar Norveç'te ilk tarikat üyesi olmuştu. Ailesini ve klanını tamamen tarikattan güdümünü sokmaya çalışırken zalim doğası da ona emellerinde yardımcı olmuş. Bu ilk elediğimiz olan Lof Gifu diye biri var. Neymiş bu? Nehrin karşısında bulunuyormuş. Kın olarak da bilinen Lof Gifu tarikatın Grand Prix Curse'daki tüm gizli asker faaliyetlerini yürüten kişiymiş. Silah temin edilmesinden ve gizli bölümlere özel emirler verilmesinden sorumlu. Veba salgını sırasında ailesini kaybeden Lof Gifu bir haydut olarak büyümüş. Daha sonra paralı asker olarak çalışmaya başlamış. paladin konumundaymış Blavok'ta. Arkadaş. Denizlere hükmediyormuş. Diğer şeyler de arttı böylece. Okay, şimdi.
Can you remind me what you do here?
As a stable hand and a gameskeeper, I am happy to help you with any matter concerning your horses or your raven.
How did you come to have such an affinity for horses, Rowan?
They were my best friends growing up. I was a sickly boy with a stammer, and the horses were the only ones who never teased me. Over time, I suppose I came to understand them as well as you may understand people. I listen when they speak, and vice versa.
May I see your stores?
Bakalım şimdi. Ah. Bizim skinli atlar, kurtlar burada şimdi. Ateş ejderi, bak bu olabilir. Siyah at, yok bana geç. Korn. Çok iyiymiş ya. Direkt kuşan bunu. Bu da kuş.
Can we do a bit of training?
Absolutely. Şimdi. Birincilik eğitim yine tekrar açar. Birincilik eğitim yine tekrar açar. Aynen.
You are an excellent rider, Eivor.
Şuna var. Arttır. Sağlam arttırır. Hızmasını arttırır. Tamam.
Today.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Bye, Eivor. That's a damn fine stable we have now. Lord, look at it.
Okay. Şimdi nahırla işimiz yok. Şurada geliştirilecek başka şeyler var. Yaptık, tamam. Hadi tamam yere. Demir harika. Şuraya bir dekorasyon koyabiliriz şimdi. Şövalye heykeli. Okay. Güzel durdu. Thor'un diğer heykelini koyacağım şuraya. Ahşap şövalye. Altın heykel. Thor.
Now I can build the most vicious crew ever to sail the rivers of England.
Our warriors now have a place to rest and train.
A fine shelter it is. When word gets out, it should attract many Jomsvikingar to fight with us. Which reminds me, a few of your raiders are chomping at the bit in hope of becoming your second. You ought to pick one.
Ah, yağmacılar. Uğraşmayacağım ya.
There is much honor to be earned fighting by your side, Eivor.
Rutbeber.
I'll be here should you call again.
Bye bye. Senin işin yok şu an. Şurası neymiş? Mokbar'ın ekmek ustası tarzına ait. Sağlık arttırıyormuş.
Feasting table will be warmer for it.
Eivor, that is kind of you. I hope one day I can repay you.
You are among friends here. There's no need.
No need, but a desire. An earnest one. I remember the good things people do for me. To warm my heart in times when kindnesses are few and far between. There was one more thing, though, if you had a moment. A grain merchant has set up downriver. I want to bring a half dozen bags home, but I would need an extra pair of hands.
I cannot help now. Maybe later.
No, Russ. Just let me know.
Okay. Şimdi şuraya. Şuraya da şunu eklesek, Loki'nin heykeli. Loki'yi de ekledik. Şimdi şurada bir yer daha var.
Greetings, Eivor.
Tell me about what you do here.
I buy and sell all manner of items. What's more, I am connected to a wide network of other traders, meaning I have access to nearly everything you could want, right here. But I cannot do much of anything if I don't have a place to work. If you can build a place for me, I can get started right away.
Okay.
I have to go. See you soon.
Always a pleasure, Eivor.
Burada eşya satıyorsun diyor.
There we are. Nice to have a more permanent spot.
Şimdi bakalım.
I've got some
We have talked so little since our first days, Yanli, and I know nothing about you. How did you come to live in England?
I wish I had a more intriguing story for you. I came from Sun Tsao, far from here, for no real reason. Curiosity, I suppose. This is not an exotic story. A young woman, excited by the prospect of travel, granted passage on a trading boat.
Do you miss your home?
Yes, often. I intend to return one day, or perhaps coax some friends and family to join me here. But I am in no hurry.
Well, you're most welcome here.
Oh, I should soon have a few spices from the East to add to our feasts. As much as I love your hospitality, your food is... Well, you are doing your best.
What have you got for me today?
Ha, bu da bunları satıyormuş yani.
Made from only the finest materials.
Satın al. Kokoreçe sarı falan filan.
You should definitely get this.
Dövmeci aynı zamanda bu. Ha, saç tasarımı falan alıyorsun buradan. Fantastik balıklar nelerdir nerelerde bulunurmuş.
Is that everything?
Aynen.
Böyle. I must take my leave.
Don't be a stranger.
Şimdi. Şunun amacı ne?
What is it you do here again?
When you hunt any animal, bring it here for a trade. And if you get something really special, I'm happy to mount it. That said, though, I can't do much until you build me a place to work. It won't do tanning hides on makeshift tables and dirt.
Okay.
I will see you later, friend.
Happy hunting! Thank you for this. Whether fur, meat, or bone, we will provide only the finest.
And if you intend to go hunting, consider bringing us your kills. We will prepare the hides and heads.
Aye. I've been mounting Petra's trophies for years, and she's a discerning woman.
In all things.
I'll keep that in mind. Enjoy your new home.
Eivor, you seem to be someone with a penchant for trophies.
I do like victories, but I rarely keep a record of them.
Your weapons show the marks of great battles. And you walk with a pride that speaks to your triumphs. Am I wrong?
You are not. Why do you ask?
To bolster our trade, of course. Wallace is the finest tanner and taxidermist in all of England. If you wish the tales of your hunts to outlast you, there is no better way than making trophies of your kills. If you defeat a rare and worthy creature, bring it to us. We will display it for you.
A good idea. Keepsakes to adorn the longhouse. Thank you, Petra.
Oh, and before you go, could you spare a moment for a small favor?
Go ahead.
For the past few evenings, I've heard the howling of a pack of wolves just beyond the border of our woods. Unchecked, they will ravage the wild game in this area. And once the deer are dead, they may turn to us.
You feel we should drive them off?
I would eliminate them entirely, with your permission, of course. And your help, if possible.
A good idea. I will join you now.
Good. A pack of wolves is a foolish thing to underestimate. Let's go. This way. I last saw them prowling around just up the hill.
You lead. I'll follow.
Our settlement is in quite a nice spot. Beautiful terrain, and the animals here are healthy and populous. But wolves are a worry. It may be why the Ragnarssons moved on. Humans upset the balance of nature, and nature pushed back.
By attacking us.
A wolf will do whatever it takes. They were displaced. Now they come to our door.
An arrival. I wonder if Volker is among them.
Come this way.
Coming.
Look here. Breadcrumbs and crusts. They must have stolen something from Tarbin's store, or off a table somewhere.
You saw breadcrumbs from where you stood.
They stand out clearly from the soil and grass. See there? Come, this way. Ah, smell that. That's a male wolf, marking his territory, warding off the competition.
How do you know it's a male?
A different odor. You pick it up.
How did you come to be such a skilled tracker?
My family were hunters and trackers, from further east than you've ever seen, I imagine. But I've lived in England for most of my life. This is where we found Wallace.
You two are siblings, as Sigurd and I are siblings. Bound by honor, not blood.
Yes. To hear my mother tell it, we came upon Wallace abandoned, a babe in the woods. We took him in. Look. The wolves made a kill here. They're in the area. Those trails. They must have dragged the poor beast away. We're getting closer. Huh. Ah, see those teeth marks on the carcass? They're different.
This is the pack's doing, not just one.
That's right. Let's go on.
So your family found Wallace in the woods?
We were traveling through the forest when I spotted a white elk ahead of us. I chased it, hoping to take it down. I lost it as I came to a clearing. And there on the ground was a wee babe, our little Wallace, swaddled and alone. Ah, look at that, the pattern on the grass. They slept here.
I'm impressed, Petra. You have a raw skill.
You have seen nothing just yet.
So you saw a white elk, and that led you to Wallace.
That's right. It felt fated. We took him in and nursed him back to health. I was scarcely more than a toddler myself then. And from that day forward, we were raised as brother and sister. Hmm. These kills are fresh. They're likely near enough to hear us. Probably fled the scene not long ago.
I think we found our wolves.
You there, get to cover. Eivor, with me, let's end this.
I'm at your side.
Not there.
Let's see you, old friend.
Şurada.
That should be all of them.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, both of you.
Are you all right? Were those your sheep?
They were. God take them. They were all I had in the world. Poor blighters never stood a chance. I lost my cows some months back. Now the sheep are gone. Drowning Jesus, what sort of farmer am I?
I'm sorry for your loss. With the wolves gone, you can recover in peace.
Not without the blessings of God, I won't. But I shall try.
You have your life, farmer. With that alone, you can always rebuild.
Eivor, hold. I hear something.
What? I don't hear... Oh! Oh, goodness gracious me! Felix! Rosemary! My beauties! You're alive! Come here, my precious angels!
Well, that worked out.
This was grand, Eivor. You hunt almost as well as you fight.
Give me a few weeks, I'll learn to track as well as you. Or better.
I would be happy to be so humbled.
This was a joy, Petra. Do not hesitate to call on me the next time you spot any errant beasts.
You were the first on my list, Eivor. See you soon.
Şimdi Kemik hastasını arttırıyormuş bu da. Tamam. Atışmalar için bu da. Ölmem ne, okey. Şurayı da açalım. Etkileş. Octavio'nun gazine koleksiyonu üstüne düşüyor. Onu Roma'nın eserlerine getir ve karşıda seni ödüllendirsin. Yap.
Suppose it will do for the moment, though it lacks the grandiosity of the Empire at its peak.
You don't like it?
It's not that. It's just not terribly Roman. It needs more. More relics, more statuary, more Rome. If you happen to find any distinctly Roman artifacts on your travels, bring them by. We can make something of this mess yet. Salve, Eivor. We have not yet been introduced. I am Octavian Claudius Britannicus, a collector of Roman relics.
Quite a name you have.
If you are wondering what good I will bring to the settlement, you need only look to the greatest empire the world has ever known.
Yes, I've seen their great ruins. Always impressive.
But you have not seen them restored to their former glory, and I can help. Eivor, have you ever been in love?
Why do you ask?
I wonder if you know the feeling of having your very heart pulled from your chest as it pursues the elusive object of your desire. I wonder if you have ever known the bitter agony of seeing your beloved in the arms of another. I have known such a pain, and Maximus was its source. Oh, God, no! No. Maximus is a snake and a leech. A slime-encrusted, blood-sucking viper of a man. He stole from me my beloved. A perfectly preserved statue of a legionnaire. It is all I desire in this world. Last I heard, Maximus was holed up in and around London, holding my beloved captive, leering and pawing at it, no doubt. If you should ever see him, give him my regards. By that, I mean spit on him. Then recover my statue.
Is it recovered?
Can you remind me what you do here?
If you find any Roman artifact...
Anladım. Tamam.
I must be on my way.
Bonum fortunum in your travels, Eivor.
Okay. Şimdi... Burada tamam. Şimdi şuraya bir... Aynen. Sakım Söğüt. Şuraya bir ağaç ekleyeceğim de taştan yaratık. Batman bir kontra da ikide. Alfred. Şu anman lahide. Şuraya lahit koyacağım diyeceğim de hayat çeşmesi daha güzel durur gibi ya. Burası da okey. Devam edelim gezmeye. Şöyle bir... Şurada ne var? Ziyafet etkisine. Tavuk çiftliği. Güzel. Burada tavuklar var herhalde aynı. Şimdi
this land, my friend.
Burayı yaptık. Şurayı yaptık. Şuraya gidelim.
I have some new designs.
I have to get...
See you later, A4.
Look at that. Tamam. Ah, şurayı geliştirebiliriz. Tahıl tarlası. Midgard yılanı. Loki'ye ekledik Midgard yılanını. Tamam. Okey. Sığır çiftliği menzil aktarıyor. 5. Burada tamam. Şurası var.
Good day.
Arsane.
Generous one.
Gemiyi geliştirebiliriz artık. Güzel. Yok, geç. Yok. Ejder çoğalıyor böyle. Şunu koşan direkt. Mesela ikili. Cenaze ateşi falan filan. Bütün renkli ejder şu an. Tamam, kuşum. Eser kalkanı. Set zaten. Okay.
Enough for today.
Tell me about what you do here.
Whatever you need for your longship, my husband and I are happy to help. We have quite an eye for these things.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Don't be a stranger.
Okay. Aman evini de hallettik. Şuraya bir dekor koyalım.
Going here.
Are you the man in charge?
It's my grandfather, really. But he says the best way to learn responsibility is by working. Besides, between you and me, I'm better at it. More of a people person, you know?
I do. It's good to have you. Both of you. I have something that...
Only a true fisherman could catch this one.
Ödüllerde bunlarmış.
These are good fish.
I must take my leave.
Come visit again soon.
Okay, what are the shunuk? Sen bol ağacı. Birleştirebiliriz artık. Şöyle yanan ağaç. Varsa ki varsa. Açamsak daha iyi. Ben varsak kalsın ya. Çam ağacı. ziyafet veriyorsun. Okey. Şuraya bir anıt koyacağım. Şurada bir yer daha var. Koş koş koş. Cenaze ateş. Cephanelik. Burayı modla açsak nasıl olur? Dur bakayım. Modla deneyeceğim de. Nasıl olacak? Ha, modla oluyor. Aha burası. Da.
Ya!
Oh, dur. Bekle. Tamam. olmuş bu. Haritacı gözden kaçırdın diye ayak kaynaklar.
This is fine work, really. Thank you for seeing this done.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
Always easier to follow a map.
Haritayı boşu.
Let me update your map with this. I'm here if you need anything more.
Tamam, devam et.
I must be on my...
Farewell, Eivor.
Şurası. Bu ne? Ziyafet etkisi mi? Meyda için sıcak bir yuva. Geçebiliriz, tamam. Burada maksimum yattım ama bitti. Burası ney mesela? Gel şimdi tak bakış. Kalmadı gibi ya. Ne varsa geliştirdik. Bakıyorum, bakıyorum. Tamam, yok gibi yani. Orayı da yaptık. Okey abi. Şuna gel bakayım. Şu görevi de yapıp bölüm sana vereceğim. Şurada bir şey var. Evet, yukarıp da koyalım. Ne koyabiliriz? Koyduk, koyduk. Ateş, mateş.
Tarbin.
Eivor.
I can lend a hand.
That's a relief. I did not fancy asking Holger.
Tarbin, what brought you to our clan?
Your reputation. Heard folk say a band of hard-drinking, Battlesguard warriors had washed up on shore. Said you had settled in the center of Mercia, taking in whatever flotsam, jetsam, and jumble of misfits came to your docks.
And this appealed to you?
More than anything. Always been a bit of a drifter. The thought of settling in a rowdy camp felt like a good balance. And being a baker, I knew my services would not be sniffed at.
I did not take you for a baker when we met. You have the look of someone who swings an axe.
I do hear that a lot.
But baking is your only craft, is that right?
I have always enjoyed it. And I have always been good at it. But when I'm not able to find such work, I take odd jobs where I can. So long as I can work with my hands.
Well, we have that in common.
A question, Eivor. You're a warrior, a fighter. That much I know. But if you could stop fighting, what would you do?
You asked the wrong question. I can stop fighting, but to do so would be to deny the essence of who I am. I think you mean, if I had to stop fighting, what would I become?
No, you've given me the answer I wanted. It's good you found what calls you. A rare and happy thing.
Yes, yes, I see you both. What can I... It's you. What are you doing in Mercia?
Collecting grain. 30 silvers worth, if you can spare it. I do have the coin.
Right. Well, take what you need and get going.
That should cover it. Thank you kindly.
Of course. And you, you take good care of yourself. Yeah?
Is that your usual vendor? He seemed a little surprised to see you.
Did he? Well, could be he knows somebody who looks like me. There's no shortage of big bearded men around here, yeah?
I suppose not. Your question earlier, what would I do if I weren't a warrior? I would ask the same of you. Is baking bread your greatest wish?
Is there something wrong with wanting to bake bread? The Romans baked bread. The Egyptians baked bread.
It is a fine trade, but is it your calling?
It is my calling to feed people, I'd say. To be of service to those I care for, and who care for me. That brings me joy.
But that way, it is a noble pursuit.
I don't know that it's noble. It is simply what gets me up in the morning. It gives me purpose for the rest of my day.
Need help with your grain?
No need, no need. I'll do the rest myself. Bring it in and put it where I like.
All right. It was good to speak with you, Tarbin. A welcome diversion.
You too, Eivor. Thank you for your help.
Παριάδε. Τα μάθω, παίρνω ψώνα.